Hello, welcome to another Genetic Algorithms video. In this video, I want to talk about an improved fitness function. Now, there are so many different ways you can improve a fitness function and ways that you could design and think about a fitness function. And I less mean this video to be like, here's one thing, but I just want to use this video as a way to start thinking about how this fitness function is your creative thing that you're creating and anything you could imagine you could possibly do with that function. So if you recall this particular example, which is a search problem, it's a simulation running a genetic algorithm to evolve the phrase to be or not to be. And every time I run this, it's typically taking somewhere between like 300 and 600 generations to get to the correct phrase. And you can see it took 554 generations. So let's talk about the fitness function. Let's talk about the fitness function. And the way the fitness, if I were to graph that fitness function, right? This is number of, the x-axis is the number of characters correct. Okay? So the more characters you get correct, the higher the fitness. Right? Yay! More characters correct, higher the fitness. And this works. Because I might have, I might have a phrase that's like 20 characters long, and I have, 16 characters correct versus 17 characters correct. This has a higher fitness. It's going to be more likely to be picked as in the selection process to have its genetic information passed to the next generation. But there's a problem here. What if this phrase were not 20 characters long? But what if it were 2,000 or 200,000 or 2 million characters long? Let's think about the fitness values of certain random phrases. So one random phrase might have 391,263 characters correct. And another one might have 391,264 characters correct. Now this one is better than this one. And in fact, having just one more character correct, it's really a lot better than the other one. And we really want to make it more likely to have its genetic information passed down to the next generation. But if you take this value and divide it by 2 million, and you take this value and divide it by 2 million, the number you get from this value is only a tiny bit bigger than this one. So in other words, this value is only a tiny bit bigger than this value, but I really want that one that's a tiny bit higher to be much more likely to be picked because I want my evolution to happen efficiently and faster and all of that. So a simple way around this is to make the fitness function exponential. What if I could have the more characters you have correct, the higher your fitness is exponentially. And there are a variety of ways you could do this. I could say the fitness is 2 to the n, being n is the number of characters correct. I could take n squared or n to the fourth power. I could probably come up with some other fancier math to do, but I just want to get you thinking that these are the types of issues that you want to think about. And in fact, let's go back to this program, and I'm going to go to the fitness function, which is here, right? And I'm just going to say, as a very simple thing, I'm going to say this.fitness equals power this.fitness squared. So this is me taking fitness to the second power. And I could have just said this.fitness times this.fitness, but whatever. I'm doing this.fitness squared. And now let's run it again. And you'll have to sort of trust in me at this point, but I ran this about 4 or 5 times, and it's solving it between about 300 and 600 generations. Let's run it again. We can play some music while we wait. There's no music. Oh, I didn't have to wait very long. 240. Let's run it again. Boy, it's taking a long time. Oh boy, this is not good. That was an anomaly. Run again. 217? That's pretty good. 236? You can see I've improved, and I could even go to the fourth power, right? Ah, 120. wrong button. Refreshed. 89. So you can see that exponential fitness function really has improved things. And so this is something you could consider. So you could also go back to the smart rockets example as an exercise. Find the smart rockets example that I made in the previous coding challenge and see if you can use that distance, the distance to the target, which is part of the fitness, and use an exponential function to see if you can make that particular evolution happen more quickly or kind of work more efficiently. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video soon.